The nighttime shadows disappear, and with them go all your tears. For the morning will bring joy for every girl and boy. So don't crying's not a bad thing, but stop your crying when the birds sing. It may be hard to discover that you've been left.
Another golden oldie, Don't Let the Sun Catch You Crying by Gerry and the Pacemakers. This was actually a request from the forums. I didn't know the song. It was very nice to learn, I have to say. And relatively easy, depending on, of course, your level of playing. So, how Gerry Marsden plays it is simply with chords in the key of C. Raising the guitar with a half step, so just plays the capo here on the first fret, even though I've also seen him without, and of course put it there where it fits the range of your voice, of course. But for this lesson I stay with the original one, so this would be the absolute key of C sharp. Regardless, we play this with shapes in C. And then the usual suspects are pretty much all in there, I guess. So like a C major, an F major, a G major, an A minor, and well, okay, one chord is out of the key, an E major or E dominant 7, yes, then D minor, yes, okay. Now, a few things about those chords, in particular for C and for F. Those will be played with a 7 in there, so a C major 7 and an F major 7, so including the 7 on its scale, the 1, the 3rd, the 5th, and the 7th, and then you have a major 7 chord. For C it is actually really easy, just take off your index, so you leave the 2nd string open, which is now a B, relative to the capo of course, and then you're already there. As for F, if we would play a little F, if the bigger one is too hard for you, then all you need to do is actually the same thing, but now on the top string. So you need to fret the 2nd string though, but leave the top string open, so that one is instead of an F is an E, and you have an F major 7. So you just go back and forth between the two. Personally, and I think he does as well, really like to use a bigger one, so I have a low F there in the bass. Like this would be a barred F, of course, but you want to leave the top string open. But if you take off the bar, then the 2nd string is open there too, and you don't want to do that. So now take over the 2nd string, I mean with your index, wrap your thumb around the neck, so you really have this baseball grip there, and try to keep the top string open there, of course. If you're not used to this sort of grip, then it might be a little challenging. Make sure though, you put your thumb, or at least your thumb moves first, and then the other fingers come in. I'll elaborate a little bit more on that in the lesson, just, you know, to point out little details for changing chords and such. However, then a G and a G7, I would say go for this fingering, do not go for this one going to the dominant 7, this switching back and forth, it's really not efficient. So play it as such. Then all you need to do is take the high G down to an F, like so, and then you're there. Alright, A minor, simply as so, E7, actually he indeed plays as an E7, taking off his, leaving the 4th string open, I should say. Actually he does, I think, the same for A minor, so A minor 7. In this case, leaving the 3rd string open, yes, and for E7, the 4th string open, if I didn't say that already. Going back and forth between those two. A D minor, like this. I would say use your little finger there, and G7, and so on. So I pretty much talked to you through all the chords already. I'll show you those in close-up, don't worry about it. What makes the song a little bit more interesting, in my opinion, is how to strum it. You could do this like the easy way, like so. So basically like the folk strum. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Or do the rock strum, so also playing B3, and then you get this 1, 2, 3, 4, and down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down. I would go back and forth between those two strummings. It is nice to emphasize the end of beat 2. How he mostly does it though is because the song is quite slow-ish, so it makes you automatically already want to double your downstroke. So you're going from the speed of 8s to the speed of 16s, also from single time to double time. So all of a sudden it goes something like... This is kind of what he does. And occasionally he throws in an 8 note there, but in general he would play like at the speed of 16s, I think. A big downstroke on 1. That's kind of what you hear throughout the song. And then emphasizing the end of B2 and 4. 1, and of course 1. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2. Or go back and forth between one speed and the other, which I tend to do here and there, something like this. Yeah. Down, up, down, here and there, throw in an occasional bouncer. Anyway, I do elaborate on this, of course, there as well. On the other end, if it throws you off, you know, then you might want to stick with one speed and really play it well from there. But kind of just how you could go from one to the other, which happens, well, more often when you're in between. It's kind of slow, it's not really... you could do one or the other, actually, depending on the feel of the song. Anyway, so the chords, of course, the strumming there, the progression is really easy, so we're done with that one, I suppose, in no time. The thing to, when you're done with those two hands, are more about how to approach it dynamically. You know, when you get to the ending of this going back and forth between C and F, you go to G, you want to build it up. Kinda, you know, indeed, build it up there, or when you head into the bridge, you're coming from F. We know that crying's not a thing. Well, and so on. So, before you get into it, going for those downstrokes in order to, well, burst into the bridge. And then take it down immediately. It may be hard. Gently and subtly, softly strum from there. Okay, so those are the things that I will point out, and I hope you can incorporate it into your playing. The lesson is now, of course, in the target program at Totally Guitars. I think besides this one, we have, what is it, Ferry Cross the Mersey, and also You'll Never Walk Alone, of course. This one, who knows, I might get into another one if the request is there. Anyway, if you want to learn it, have more details, more close-up, and all that stuff, then check it out at totallyguitars.com.